Hello children, let me welcome you to the Virtual Training Center of the Brihan Mumbai Mahanagar Palika. My name is Shraddha teacher. Children, we are in the middle of the COVID-19 pandemic, isn't it? Because of that, we are not able to go to school. But that doesn't mean that we are going to stop learning. We are going to meet here regularly through the Virtual Training Center to learn many lessons in EVS. So come on, let's go to a lesson in EVS.
Come on children, let us start with another lesson in standard 4th EVS 2. And here we are studying the glorious story of the great king of Maharashtra, that is Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj. And today children, we will start with the 8th lesson in our textbook, that is defeat of the internal enemies. So now we all know that Shivaji Maharaj decided at a very young age that he wants his own rule in his own country. He did not want any foreigners ruling his country and he wanted Hindavi Swaraj. And for that, he got a lot of inspiration from not only his father but also his mother. His mother was the driving force behind all the success of Shivaji Maharaj. So in the previous lesson, children, when we talked about Swaraj, the first conquest, we talked about how Shivaji Maharaj conquered various forts. So the first fort that he took in under his control was the Torana fort. Alright. And then we saw that afterwards he captured the forts like Kondana, Purandar, etc. So now when he started moving swiftly and he started capturing one fort after another in the Mawal country or the region of Mawal, the 12 Mawals or the Bara Mawals as they have called, the people in the Mawal region, they started having a lot of confidence on the work and the courage that Shivaji Maharaj displayed. Okay, so what did they do? They realized that there was nothing that could stop Shivaji Maharaj now. Why? Because he already had the fort of Torana and the fort of Rajgarh under his control. So what did they do? They were very, very happy to side with Shivaji Maharaj. Then why did Shivaji Maharaj had to use force and why did he have to defeat the internal enemies? So now if the Mawlas were all with Shivaji Maharaj, then what was the problem? Who were these internal enemies? Okay, and why were they against Shivaji Maharaj? So we will see all that story in this particular lesson. So remember children, Shivaji Maharaj, he had to use force in order to defeat many of his internal enemies. And remember, most of the internal enemies were also his own people. They were his own relatives. Okay, so let us see how he started out on this journey of defeating internal enemies of the Swaraj. So as we all know, the Mawlas of the 12 Mawals, they gathered around Shivaji and they were ready to do his bidding. Okay, so most of the Mawlas, most of the people of the 12 Mawal region, they were very much liking the work being done by Shivaji Maharaj because they also wanted Swaraj. They also did not want to live as gulams or as slaves of someone else. So the Mawlas of the 12 Mawals, they gathered around Shivaji Maharaj and they were ready to do anything for him. Ready to do his bidding means whatever he asked of them, whatever he wanted from them, they were ready to give him. And they lived for Swaraj and they were willing to die for Swaraj as well. So they were very happy to live for Swaraj and die for Swaraj. They wanted Shivaji Maharaj to hold his head high up in front of all these rulers, the Shahas, the Mughal emperors, the with people that we saw in the previous lesson, the Portuguese, okay, the Siddhis. So Shivaji Maharaj, they wanted him to hold a high head against all these foreign powers in Maharashtra. So they lived for Swaraj and they were willing to die also for that particular Swaraj, to see Shivaji Maharaj held high up. They were ready to sacrifice their lives also for it. Now, they were simple Maratha folk. They were not very, people from the royal families or people who were very rich. They were very simple Maratha folk. and they loved Shivaji more than their life, and they always supported whatever Shivaji Maharaj told them, and they were always ready to follow him also. But this was only one side of the coin, children. Everywhere, all around Maharashtra, do you think people in those times supported Shivaji Maharaj? No. There were some people who were very jealous of Shivaji's achievements. See, look at their faces. Do they look happy? They were not at all happy. And they were very jealous. They did not want Shivaji Maharaj to do so many good things. Okay? And they were very comfortable being servants of Adil Shah. So Adil Shah would give them some small jagir, and Adil Shah would take care of them also, and they would live like kings, and they would not have to do anything. So they were very happy being that. And they knew that if Shivaji Maharaj would try to establish a Swaraj in Maharashtra, they might have to give all this up. They might have to give up all the luxuries. They were very jealous, and they were also very selfish people. They were very comfortable being servants of Adil Shah. Okay, so you can see here. So they started plotting against Shivaji Maharaj. They started thinking that no, somehow or the other, we should stop Shivaji Maharaj from establishing Swaraj in Maharashtra. So see how people are, and see how people think. They do not think about the welfare of the general public. They think about only their good. So these people were those kind of people. And what happened? There were two people called as Khandoji and Baji Ghorpade. Now these two Sardars, they were a little bit brave, and they were also Sardars in the service of Adil Shah. So these two Sardars were working for Adil Shah, and they were very, very loyal to Adil Shah. They did not want to ever give up on Adil Shah, or they did not want to take a side which was different from Adil Shah's side. And the Shah incited them also against Shivaji. The Shah was getting very, very uncomfortable that Shivaji is conquering so many forts and so many people are along with Shivaji. So very soon Shivaji might topple me down. So that is why what this Adil Shah started doing, he started teaching these people against Shivaji. So who were these people? Khandoji, Baji Ghorpade. They started plotting against Shivaji Maharaj. And who was the person who was helping them? Who was the person who was encouraging them to do it? It was Adil Shah. Okay? And Shivaji Maharaj realized that very soon he will have to bring such people to book. Such people to book means he will have to punish such people, or he will have to teach them a lesson. Otherwise, what would happen? He will not be able to establish Swaraj in his own land. So he realized this, that the Nimbalkars, the Ghorpades, and of course there were the Mores also. There is a very long story about the Mores, which we will see very soon. Okay, so he decided that he will have to teach them a lesson. Now, these two people, that is the Khandoji and Baji Ghorpade, what they started doing is, they started creating a lot of trouble in the Kondana district. See, this is the Kondana area. Now, we don't have a district called the Kondana district, but in those times, there was a district for administration. Shivaji used to call it the Kondana district. So these people started doing a lot of trouble there. But Shivaji Maharaj was more than a match for them. What they used to do? They used to go there and they used to attack the people, and they used to trouble the people, and they used to harass the people. Okay? And Shivaji Maharaj had already decided that he will teach them a lesson, and he was more than a match for them. Or you can say that Khandoji and Baji Ghorpade were no match at all for Shivaji Maharaj. So what did he do? Shivaji defeated and he drove them out of his territory. So see, that was how brave Shivaji Maharaj was. Now, there was another problem, or there was another, you can say, Sardar who was creating a lot of trouble for Shivaji Maharaj. And that was Bajaji Naik Nimbalkar of Faltan. Now, he was Shivaji's own brother-in-law. That is, he was a very, very close relative of Shivaji Maharaj. But you will see that Shivaji Maharaj had to fight many battles against him also. So, you see, fighting with outsiders and defeating outsiders is easier than fighting with your own people. When your own people start plotting and planning against you, they start troubling you, it becomes a little difficult. But He fought many battles with Bajaji Naik Nimbalkar. Okay, and later on, but the members of his family stood along with Shivaji Maharaj and they supported Shivaji Maharaj in his endeavor to bring Swaraj to Maharashtra. Now, after that, you will see that there was one more very close relative of Shivaji. He was called Sambhaji Mohite and he belonged to a place called Supe. So, you remember we saw the names of some Jagirs. We saw Supe there. Okay. So, he belonged to Supe and he was a very close relative also of Shivaji. But he started plotting against Shivaji. He started making plans against Shivaji. Now, what did Shivaji do? He arrested him at Supe and he banished him to Karnataka. So he sent him away from Maharashtra to Karnataka because he was creating problem here for Shivaji. So with Shivaji, duty came first and relatives always came afterwards. So what was more important for Shivaji? It was his duty. He would not see whether Bajaji Naik Nimbalkar is his own brother-in-law or whether Sambhaji Mohite is a very close relative of his. He never kept all these things in mind. What was important for him? Swaraj was important for him. Duty was important for him. All his relatives and friends came later. Okay. Now I told you we are going to discuss about a very, very important enemy of Shivaji and he was Chandra Rao More of Jawali. So now this Chandra Rao More, his name was actually Yashwant Rao. Okay, so let us see how he came to be named as Chandra Rao More and then what was Shivaji's role in his life and then why did he turn against Shivaji. So this is a long story, so let us see that now. So the greatness of Shivaji's achievement was recognized and applauded everywhere. Applauded means he was praised everywhere. People everywhere were looking up to Shivaji Maharaj. He captivated the hearts of his people. So, wherever he went, okay, he looked after the welfare of his people and we saw that for him, caste and creed and religion was not at all important. So, anyone who was living under him in a Swaraj was equal to him. So, that is why he created a lot of love in the minds of the people. And he captivated the heart of all the people wherever he went. But there were some people who did not like this at all. Okay, they looked upon Shivaji as a mole in the eye. Now, what is the meaning of a mole in the eye? Now, see, when some dust gets into your eye, how do you feel? You feel very irritated, isn't it? Your eye starts itching and scratching. So imagine if you have a mole. A mole is a kind of a small foda or a pimple inside your eye. That thing will trouble you so much, isn't it? So the same way, Shivaji Maharaj had become a mole in the eye for many people. And the More of Jawali was one such person. Now who was this person? Who was the More? So More was a Jagirdar of Jawali. There was this place called Jawali and More was the Jagirdar of Jawali. Now this Jagir, the Jagir which More had, it extended from Raigad to Koina Valley. So there was this place, this entire strip of land which was under the More and he was called as the Jagirdar of Jawali. Okay, now who had made him the Jagirdar? He thought that Adil Shah is his master and Adil Shah had made him the Jagirdar. That is what he was having a lot of love and affection for Adil Shah. And Adil Shah, what he had done, his name was Yashwant Rao, but Adil Shah had called him Chandra Rao, or he had conferred the title upon him as Chandra Rao. So now he was called as Chandra Rao. Okay, and he was very proud also that he had this big title which was conferred to him by Adil Shah. He was against Shivaji Maharaj. Okay, but there was a point which was very, very, you can say, which was a strength for Chandra Rao More. And what was that point? That point was his Jagir of Jawali. Now, why was it his strength? Because Jawali was covered with such a thick forest that even during broad daylight, the sun rays hardly penetrated it. So you can imagine how the forest must have been. The forest was so thick and the trees were so tall and the trees were so close to each other that even during daylight, if you were inside the forest, you would feel that it is night time. Because there was no light, there would be no light at all. The sunrays could not penetrate the forest. So it was covered with a thick forest. And not only that, when there is a thick forest, you know what comes along with it? It was full of wildlife. So tigers and wolves and bears, they roamed freely in the Jawali forest. So this is how the forest looked like. Okay? And now it was very difficult. So imagine someone who stays inside this kind of a place, or whose jagir, as part of his jagir, he's got this kind of a difficult place. He definitely has an advantage, isn't it? But Shivaji Maharaj would never be discouraged. Okay? So whenever this More, Chandrarao More, was faced with any kind of trouble, what he would do was, he would go and hide inside Jawali. And then no one would dare to go and try and find out where this More was. But did Shivaji feel scared? Was Shivaji discouraged because of all these things? No, we will see that Shivaji was not scared of the forest. Neither was he scared of all the wildlife, that is the tigers, the wolves and the bears within the forest. Now let us see what relationship Shivaji and Chandra Rao shared. Okay, so now Chandatta Daulat Rao More, he died in 1645. And there was a big fight as to who would become the next ruler after the death of Daulat Rao More. There was this big fight which was going on. Now, who helped Yashwant Rao More to ascend the throne? It was Shivaji. So Shivaji backed Yashwant Rao More, who with Shivaji's help ascended the gaddi as Chandra Rao. So because of Shivaji's help, because of Shivaji's support, and you can see at that time both of them were young. Okay, even Shivaji was young and Yashwant Rao More was also young. So he became the king. He could sit on the gaddi, that is the throne, because of all the help and cooperation which was provided to him by Shivaji Maharaj. Now, at that time, when Shivaji backed him, he promised. So in return for Shivaji's help, Yashwant Rao promised him that I will help you, okay, in your struggle for Swaraj. And he also promised him that I will pay you an annual tribute. That is, every year I will pay you a particular amount so that you can use it in order to establish Swaraj. But then, did he remember all this? Because now we are looking at a story where both of these people, that is Shivaji and More, they are enemies of each other. So how did they become enemies? They became enemies because this person forgot about his promise. Alright? And he became very impertinent. That is, he became very, very selfish. He became very, very proud. And also he became troublesome. Why troublesome? Because he started attacking Shivaji's territory and harassing the people. So he would not have done any help for Shivaji. Maybe if he had not paid the amount that had promised him as annual tribute, it would have been okay. But what did he do? He started now troubling and harassing the people who lived in Shivaji's territory. And that was like the last straw for Shivaji Maharaj. And he decided that unless More was punished, he would remain a constant danger to Swaraj. So he now decided to punish More, punish Yashwant Rao More, or as he is now called, Chandra Rao More. And then they started the war of words. War of words means he first tried to convince him. He told him, if you rebel, you will die. That is, if you go against me, if you go against establishment of Swaraj in Maharashtra, you will die. So first he tried to explain to him. First he tried to make him understand. So what did he do? Shivaji first sent a stiff note to Yashwant Rao More. Stiff note means very strict letter to Yashwant Rao More. And what did he write in the letter? He said, you call yourself the Raja, but I am the Raja of this territory. This kingdom is Lord Shiva's gift to me. So do not call yourself the Raja. Okay, you remember he took the oath of Swaraj? Alright, so he said, do not call yourself the Raja because I have taken the oath of Swaraj in the presence of Lord Shiva, and this kingdom is Lord Shiva's gift to me. So now he read the letter and he got very angry and he sent a very rude reply to Shivaji. So in a very rude reply, Yashwant Rao said, you are a Raja of only yesterday. Who gave you this kingdom? If you come to Zawali, you will be trapped. Why trapped? Because it is a thick jungle. By the grace of God, I have received from Adil Shah the title of Raja. He has also, in his graciousness, given me a throne. Okay? And he has also given me the title, the panoply of a Raja. Panoply means all the third part of a Raja. If you start any trouble here, you will be badly hurt. So I said, you remember that if you try to create any kind of trouble for me, he said, I am Raja. Why I am Raja? Because he has made me the Raja. Adil Shah has made me the Raja. And who has made you the Raja? I do not know how you became the Raja. Okay? So he said, if you try to trouble me, then what will I do? I will teach you a very bad lesson. Alright, so that is what he told in his reply to Shivaji Maharaj. So see, Shivaji Maharaj tried his best to see to it that there would be no war, there would be no trouble, and there would be no violence. But did that work? No, it did not. So again, Shivaji replied, give up Zawali and your pretensions to kingship. That is, you are not actually a king. You are only a pawn or a mora in the hand of Adil Shah. So you give up your pretensions. Come before your master with folded hands and accept his service. You will refuse to do so at the risk of your own life. So he said, rebel and you will die. Alright, but did he agree? He did not agree. So Shivaji had to start thinking about how to conquer Zawali. But now the conquest of Zawali was a very difficult operation. Why? Because it was covered with thick forests and also it was protected by the impregnable Rairi fort. Impregnable means you cannot enter, you cannot break into this fort. It is very difficult to break into this particular fort. And More also had a lot of followers who would support him. Alright, so Shivaji made thorough preparations. After making thorough preparations, he attacked Zawali. And what happened? Yashwant Rao held out for about a month. For one full month, he fought Shivaji. But he suffered very, very heavy losses. And he had to escape to Rairi. From Zawali, he had to run away to Rairi along with his family. So Shivaji, once he ran away from there, once Yashwant Rao ran away, Shivaji conquered Zawali. And then what did he do? He knew that Yashwant Rao has gone to Rairi, so he marched to Rairi. Okay? And Yashwant Rao fought desperately in Rairi also for 3 months, but he had to give up. He had to come and he had to accept the terms and conditions of, or the leadership of Shivaji Maharaj. Okay? So this was a story of the More of Zawali. Now let us talk about Fort Raigad or Kile Raigad as it is called. So the conquest of Zawali was a very important landmark. Now this doubled the boundaries of Shivaji's Swaraj, and Yashwant Rao's army too joined the forces of Shivaji. So the borders of Shivaji's Swaraj now was going on extending, and the area under Swaraj was becoming bigger and bigger day by day. And very soon you will see Yashwant Rao's army also joined the forces of Shivaji. And the strong Rairi fort became a part of Swaraj. I told you, it was a impregnable fort, but that now became part of Swaraj. Shivaji was very highly pleased to have this fort under his control. He was very happy that this fort was now under my control because it was a very strong fort. Now the picture that you're seeing in here in this screen, on the screen now, is a recent picture of this fort. Okay, it is not in a very good condition now, but then the government is doing everything to bring it back to its glory. And he changed the name of this fort to Raigad. Alright, and later on he built a new fort on the Borpya hill nearby, and it was called as Pratapgarh. So this is how Shivaji brought all the people who were against him, right from Kandoji and Baji Ghorpade to Bajaji Naik Nimbalkar to Sambhaji Mohite and to Yashwantrao More under his control. So this is how he defeated all of the internal enemies which were there and who were a threat to his Swaraj. Okay, so this was lesson number 8 for you children, defeat of internal enemies. Now after you finish watching the entire video, like I always do, I have certain exercises for you and certain assignments for you. So come on, let us see what they are. So children, now you have watched the video. So after you watch the video now, you will have to complete a few simple tasks. Now you might have watched the video on your computers or your laptops or your mobile phones. Now after you watch the video, what will you do? You will please go to the description box which is given below the video. So what is the description box? See, the description box looks like this. Alright, and after you go to the description box, you will see that there are a few questions there. Now what are these questions about? These questions are about the lesson that we just learned or the video that you just watched. So what will you do? You will think back properly about the lesson and you will try and answer these questions and note down the answers in your notebook if you want. Okay, after that we have another task waiting. You will also click on the link which you will find in the description box to fill up the Google form. So now what is the Google form, children? It is nothing but a simple form. There are a few simple questions there about the video which you just saw and also about yourself. So these are the tasks now that you will have to complete after you watch each video.
So children, wasn't that a very interesting lesson? I'm sure you learned a lot of new things in this lesson. If you have liked this video, please hit the like button and also subscribe to my video so that you will get to see all the videos which I keep posting regularly.